In this video, I'm going to attempt to answer the question I probably get asked the most on the channel. Why do I continue to train learners to use an electrician's knife when stripping cables? And I haven't converted over to something like this combination wire strippers, especially when we're stripping things like twin and CPC, often called twin and earth cables. However, I would like to suggest I've also got videos on the channel where I use the electrician's knife when working with flex, steel wire armoured and SY flex when terminating it. But in this video, we're going to address the reason behind me use an electrician's knife when stripping twin and CPC cable. So if I bring the camera in, let's have a look and see if I can justify the use of this tool. Let's start with the most obvious one then. It's considerably cheaper to have a fixed blade electrician's knife in our toolkits at Tresham College than it is to have a set of flat twin and CPC cable strippers in there, because they are considerably dearer than the actual electrician's knife. However, I'm sure you're saying now, well, why don't we have three or four of these on a shadow board and learners can share them? At the very start of the course, we spent about 12 weeks working on twin and CPC or twin and earth cables. And that means that you've got 20 learners in the workshop, probably all waiting for these to come round. Why would that be? Well, let's just strip a piece back. This is a bit of 2.5. So we place them through the center of the body, simply pull. And you can see already the mechanical protection's been removed. If we go in again, we can actually strip back the insulation around the conductors, and you can see already, I'd imagine I'm already sold you on these, how easy they are to work with. So that's great, that's a real advantage that they are quick. There are some disadvantages. They only go up to 2.5 millimeters squared, and we work with 4 and 6 mil throughout the course as well, which these are no good for. And also the fact that we can't get them into a box very well. So let's see that. So if I take myself a box and I've got myself a piece of three core cable here. If I slide it into the box itself to about the appropriate position, obviously we would have clipped this down, etc. And I just make a mark against where I'd like it to be, about 15 mil in. Let's see if we can strip this three core using these twin and CPC or twin and earth strippers. Let's wind it through the body. And then all of a sudden there, I'm stuck. I can't get it in any further than that. If I pull that, I'll just pull it back out and you see the line. These are a bit difficult to pull off. There we go. So you can see that much of the outside mechanical protection would still be present inside the box where I don't want to see it. That's because these strippers will not get in fur enough to strip it. If I was to use my electrician's knife, I've seen it on the channel many times before, you can already see that I can get my knife right down into the position where I need it in order that I can strip that cable. So, and then fold it over and do the back. That's why we use the knife for that things. So this here doesn't get in fur enough and stops at 2.5. This will. Let's strip a piece of cable using my knife just to remind you of the technique. So gently score, not saw, around the actual mechanical protection itself. Then I get my learners just to snip down the middle of the cable, like so. And we leave our CPC in the middle. And what you're thinking now is, why don't you teach people just to grab hold of the CPC, Gary, and pull it down to the scorn area you've got down here? The reason being is we use lengths often less than half a meter long very early on. And what I've had before is learners actually not pull up on these, but actually pull away, and they've pulled the CPC out of the cable itself. And they've brought the CPC to me and said, what do I do now, Gary? Well, you unclip your cable and you replace it back onto the board. You know, get a lot of fuss and moaning at that stage. So we come up with a technique of actually holding our live conductors and rolling it out across our knuckles until we get down to the area in which we need to pull the actual mechanical protection off. So that meant that we didn't accidentally pull the CPC out. Now, I can't suggest in the real world that I've ever not pulled against the CPC down to my area, which I've scorn, in order that I can actually break away the mechanical protection. So that's why we do that. So we gently score around here, and that's why I always hold the two live conductors and leave the CPC alone and don't pull against it. Next, we take our knife and let's score around here. It'd be fractionally harder now, but people have said to me, oh, you might damage the actual copper, so of course it weakens it in that area. So it will break, I would imagine, but let's see how many times you have to wiggle it before it breaks. It eventually broke at that time, but it took a lot of obviously pressure to do so. But let's do the same with the combination wire strippers. Strip that back, take the same pliers, and then just get hold of it and then see what happens this time. There you go, that one broke as well. So again, I don't think there's much of a case there. Okay, I'm trying to get my learners to understand how hard to press with a knife not to damage, in this case, the inner insulation around the conductors when we're removing the mechanical protection, and how hard to press against the actual insulation in order to remove it and then not damage the copper itself. It goes back to that hand-eye coordination when you're trying to learn those skills. Remember, at college, you've got all the time in the world in which to hone your skills. When you're out in industry, you're trying to do things fast and effective. People will then say, well, Gary, why don't you teach them to use your side cutters? So why don't you take the side cutters and show them this technique just to pull it off, okay? And again, we've tried that in the past. I'll show you what happens when a learner that doesn't know hand-eye coordination and pressure, they go like this. They go strip, strip, strip. And then they come to me and go, my conductor's not very long, Gary. What do I need to do? You need to take the cable out and you need to replace it and then obviously start again. Oh, that's going to take a load of work. I've clipped it in place. It's smooth. It's got a nice bend. That's because they haven't yet learnt, obviously, the coordination required in order to strip your cables perfect every time. Let's see if this one's work hardened. So I don't think it has, but again, I can eventually get it to break. Nope. Ah, and it's broken. So again, is there a conversation to have about how hard you press with a knife? Yes, there is. Is there a conversation about using these wire strippers? They're very good, but very limited. Can we get our students to use side cutters or pliers? Not early on, because they tend to do that when they're learning to strip them back. This only goes up to 2.5, is what we said. So again, once we get to 4 and 6 mil, they've got to come up with a technique in order to strip the cables, and that would be the technique that we've just looked at. So learning to use the electrician's knife early on, and then maybe owning a set of these in the future, is a good way to build in the skills required before going to a tool that makes it a lot easier. The other issue I've got is that I can sharpen these very simply in an electrical workshop. I can sharpen the knives, and the students can as well, in order that we don't have a blunt instrument. Your feedback would be welcome here. How long do the blades in here last? Imagine these are in a workshop and we've got 12 hours of study in there, and at the first 12 weeks, everybody's on twin and CPC cables. Would the blades in here last? How easy are they to find to replace? How easy are they to replace? Your feedback would be welcome on that. So again, really good, but are these almost for the occasional stripping of conductors throughout a working day and not to be put to task every minute of every day for 12 hours a day as we go through a week at college? We found our torque screwdrivers got destroyed almost because of the amount of times they're being used. You imagine electricians doing consumer units, maybe one a day, but his torque screwdriver does all the terminations in there. We've got 20 people all doing a consumer unit all at the same time. Our torque screwdrivers failed quite quickly on the mechanical stress that we put them under. So would these last being in electrical workshops such as Tresham? So we use the knife because we believe it builds hand-eye coordination. Okay, it's cheaper for us to have it in our toolkit. We also do not pull the CPC from our conductor through the center like often they do on site, because we've seen it being pulled out. And we also know that we've got to get it into the right part of the box, and this becomes very difficult in order to get it in there. So I'm not trying to justify it, I'm just trying to answer that question. Why do I still persist with an electrician's knife? There are other tools out there, and for some of our students over the years that have struggled with hand tools, we have adapted the tools to make it a safer working environment. People were saying to me, under the Health and Safety at Work Act, you can't use that. Health and Safety at Work Act is not a massive document to read, and at no point does it say in there that Gary can't use an electrician's knife in Tresham College. However, it does say to use the safest working practices possible, and if we believed it wasn't safe for a learner to use this style of tool, then we would adapt their working practices to suit. I never advocated, so let's see what we've got here. Okay, let's go with a three core. I've never advocated things like using maybe your side cutters and then snipping down the center, getting hold of the CPC. This one should be long enough. I don't pull it out down to where we are, peeling it away. And then obviously using the side cutters again in order that we go and round here. So let's just do the best we can. Almost, oh good, I've split past it, that's nice. So get in with the side cutters and then come around this side, okay, and say that is acceptable, okay. We're looking for ends. I know we did this one and this one here. Three different methods. You can see that's used the combination wire strippers, that's used a knife, and that's used a technique that wouldn't look pretty in a box, okay? I know we're never gonna see it, okay, but that doesn't look very good at all. And obviously I like my ends to be nice and square, no damage to the inner insulation, okay? And obviously that PVC there looks a little bit untidy. Hopefully, I'm not trying to overly justify it. Everyone to their own. If you've got a better method than I have, leave it in the comments below. If there is a better way of teaching this, I apologize that I've been using this technique for 18 years. We have 10 tools in the Tresham toolbox, of which the electrician's knife is one of them. We try and build those hand-eye coordinations early on for students, especially nowadays where maybe learners come to college and haven't taken their bike apart or their skateboard apart and all the rest of it and need to work out how to do things properly, and hand tools are sometimes foreign to them. If it wasn't safe for them to use, we'd adapt the working environment to suit. Surely every college in the country would love these and love 20, 30 sets of those so students can use them. But again, it's limited. It only goes up to 2.5 and can't get into a box, of which we strip to boxes very early on as well. So as always, I hope this video has been some help.